Just breathing simply. And we're going to start to balance the length of the inhale and the exhale here. So take a few more rounds of just wherever it is, the breath. And then take a really full breath in. Let the breath exit out. You're going to inhale for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're going to continue that on your own so that you don't have to listen to me talking. So just a simple 6 count in, a simple 6 count out. At no point should your breathing feel strained or uncomfortable. At no point should you feel like you're grasping for breath or struggling with the breath. We're going to keep this rhythm going, but you're just going to get a little looser in the construct. So you don't actually have to count it. You're just going to kind of feel that general tempo. I'm going to start to circle our spine. I'm Maeve. I can't remember if I introduced myself for those of you watching back. We're going to reverse this direction. Pause in the center. Just feel that breath. Feel the effects of that movement. Just simple movement. And make your way onto your hands and your knees. And we're going to do some circles here. And you just reside in that same sort of rhythm of breath, that same tempo. Without feeling like you have to count it or be specific. Reverse that circle. Come through center, bring your forearms down to the ground, and then like a little cat-cow with your elbows down. I said forearms, you can have forearms. I've just put my elbows down and lifted my hands, so I did not do what I said for you to do, but find what works for you. Maybe whole forearm down, maybe I like the freedom of my hands up. Sphinx. Forearms come down. tops of the feet pressed down. Legs are long. And imprint your arms down, your fingers, your knuckles. Forearm plank, tuck the toes, lift up. Knees down, child's pose, stretch back. Press the palms down so much the elbows lift off the ground. Drop your ears between your biceps. And then tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Keep that energy in the arms. Inhale, right knee draws forward. Exhale, draw it up even higher. Inhale, lift up higher into this plank. Exhale, place your right foot down. Left knee to the ground. Anjane Asana, rising up. Yes, beautiful. So we're going to work a lot on tempo and pacing today. Probably not going to talk as much because this voice of mine might give out. So trust that whatever we're going to do is in you. And you're going to be perfect. And so connecting breath and movement as your priority today. Inhale, reach higher. Exhale, elbows out. Inhale. Exhale, elbows out. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Last time, inhale. Exhale, straighten your right leg. Blocks are wonderful here. Ardha Hanumanasana. Moving between Anjane Asana and Ardha Hanumanasana. Inhale, bend the front leg, reach up. Exhale, shift the hips back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last time, inhale up. Hands come forward, tuck your back toes, plank, breath in. Lower to your belly, exhale. Sphinx, inhale. Forearm plank, exhale. Inhale, Sphinx. Downward facing dog, exhale. Pause in down dog. Enjoy your breath. Take a moment. Beautiful, beautiful, yes. Inhale, glide forward. Left knee into your chest. Exhale. Lift a little higher. Inhale. Exhale, place your left foot forward. Right knee comes down. Anjane Asana. Inhale. And just get your bearings here. On the first side, I was yapping for a little bit, so you had some time to sort of acclimate to the posture. Right hip engaging. Back foot working. Front foot working. Inhale, lift a little higher. Exhale, elbows wide. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. Exhale, release the hands down, straighten the front leg. Take a few breaths here, Ardha Hanumanasana. Really nice. Linking Anjaneyasana, Ardha Hanumanasana with our breath. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, sink back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Really good. One more time. Inhale. Exhale, hands down. Plank inhale. Exhale, chaturanga or the floor. Cobra or upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Pause and breathe. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bend your knees. Look at your hands. Bring your feet to your hands. Lengthen halfway. Inhale. Bow forward. Exhale. Rise up. Inhale. Hands into your heart. Exhale. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bow. Inhale, halfway. Right foot steps back, exhale. Crescent pose, inhale. Exhale, bend the elbows. Rise up, inhale. Hands to the ground, exhale. Plank, inhale. Chaturanga or the floor. Your back bend of choice. Downward facing dog, exhale. Right leg stretches back, inhale. Knee to your chest, place your right foot forward. Crescent pose, inhale. Elbows wide, exhale. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands down, step forward. Halfway, inhale. Bow, exhale. Rise, inhale. Pause, lift the heart. Bow forward, exhale. Inhale, halfway. Left foot steps back, exhale. Inhale, crescent. Yeah, exhale, elbows wide. Reach up, inhale. Hands down, exhale. Plank, inhale. Chaturanga or the floor. Inhale, rise. Down dog, exhale. Left leg back, inhale. Exhale, knee down the center, place your foot forward. Crescent, inhale. Exhale, elbows wide. Rise, inhale. Hands and feet top of the mat. Halfway, inhale. Bow deeply, exhale. Rise, inhale. Little back bend. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, rise. Forward fold, exhale. I've never seen a place like this before. Halfway inhale. Right foot steps back, exhale. Crescent inhale. Exhale, bend the elbows wide. Reach up, inhale. Bring your hands to the ground or onto two blocks and then straighten your front leg. A little pause here. Really nice. You're going to connect to your hands a lot. Sweep your left leg up and back. If it feels good, open the hips toward the left and bend that left knee. Maybe drop a little deeper into that right heel. And maybe bring your right forearm a little closer to your right foot and drop it to the ground. Inhale, reach back up. And then exhale, bring your left knee over to your right elbow. Inhale back, three-legged dog. And then out to the left. Inhale, stretch back. Now a little pause here, lift high into your right toes. Look at your hands. If it takes you 5 jumps to get there, it's not a big deal. You're going to pop your right foot to the top of the mat. Ardha Chandrasana. Opening up. Consider bending the top leg, finding your foot with your hand. Pull the belly in, and then push the foot away. Open back up if you took the leg. Start to bend your right knee, lean forward. Stretch your left foot back. Reverse warrior back. One more breath in. Bring your hands around. Left hand floor block. Right hand to the sky. Yeah. Nice easy twist here. Beautiful. Bring your right hand onto your right hip. Pop your back foot in about halfway. Just get a little low here, and then bring the knee in all the way, and have a seat. Ardha Matsyendrasana. I'm going to stop myself before I get too far ahead. We're going to move our right foot forward, so that it's more like at the top of the knee, or at the thigh where it meets the knee. So you're giving yourself a little more space, and then we're going to wrap open from here. So a little longer position in that right leg. Really nice. Come back around, reach down for your right foot. And then just see if you can take that leg up. It's a little awkward, I know. Good. Bring it back down. Push off your left shin. Push from your right foot. Warrior three. Come on up. Inhale, rise up to stand. Lift your heart. Find a little back bend here. Engage your glutes. And bow forward. Inhale, halfway. Left foot steps back, exhale. Crescent, inhale. Elbows bend out to the side. Inhale, reach up. Bring your hands down to the ground. Pause here, blocks are wonderful. Straighten your front leg. Plant your hands, make a nice strong connection, sweep this right leg up and back. Bend the knee if it feels good, maybe drop a little deeper into that left heel. Maybe slide the left arm back and put the forearm down. Inhale, stretch back up. Right knee, left elbow. Inhale, three-legged dog. And right knee, right elbow. Inhale, stretch back. Come high into the left toes. Hop the left foot to the top of the mat. So keep the right leg lifted. Bend the left knee. Push off. And half moon on the left side. And press open. Good. Beautiful. Option to bend the top leg, find your foot. So before you push the foot away, draw the belly back, draw the ribs back, and then press away. Yeah. Beautiful. Excellent. If you have the foot, pull it toward your butt. Release it carefully. Re-extend. And then start to bend your standing leg. Reverse warrior all the way back. Well done. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Don't be afraid to adjust your stance as you're in the pose and you find that maybe you need a little longer stance or maybe you need to take your foot a little wider or whatever it might be. One more inhale. Bring that right hand around. And easy twist to your left. Use this right hand firmly into the ground. Lock that shoulder in place. Energetically, pull your feet toward each other. You're going to soften the back knee. You're going to pop the foot in about halfway. And then bring the knee to like the back of the heel. Kind of like this kind of a jobby. Yeah. And then we twist. Unravel your twist. Reach down for that foot. Just see what happens here. Mm-hmm. So good. Beautiful. Good. Rebend the leg. Step it forward, warrior three. Push off. Any arm variation that you like. Rise up to stand. Inhale. Heart to the sky. Little back bend. Bow forward, exhale. Beautiful. Inhale, halfway. Right foot steps back, exhale. Crescent pose, inhale. Hands to the ground, straighten the front leg. Pull the hip back. Plant your hands, sweep your left leg up to the sky. Open the hip if it feels good. This time, wild thing, flipping over. Come around. Left knee, right elbow. Inhale back. Out to the left, exhale. Inhale back. High into your right toes. Bend your right knee. Hop your right foot to the top of the mat. Half moon, Ardha Chandrasana. Any variation. Reverse warrior. Bring the hands around. Left hand down, right hand up. Nice easy twist. So good. We're going to come right into Ardha Matsyendrasana. Sit down and twist. Beautiful. Come back around. Reach down. Take that right foot. Extend the leg out. Good. Bring the foot back down. Warrior three. Push off. Rise up. Inhale, rise up, heart to the sky. Bow forward, exhale. Inhale, halfway. Left foot steps back, exhale. Crescent, inhale. Exhale, hands down, straighten your front leg. Plant your hands, sweep the right leg back, open up the hips, bend the knee, flip into wild thing if you would like. Yes! Come around, right knee, left elbow. Inhale, three-legged dog. And then to the right, exhale. Inhale, back. High up into those left toes, bend the left knee, hop your left foot forward. Half moon, any option. Beautiful. Oopsies. Stretch your foot back. Reverse warrior. Good. Come around, right hand down, left hand up. And then bring that right knee in. Have a seat. Twist. Reach down, find your foot. And then kick away. Good. Come forward, warrior three, last time. Rise up to stand, inhale. Bow forward, exhale. Inhale, halfway. Chaturanga, exhale. Inhale, rise. Down dog, exhale. Inhale, lift your heels, bend your knees, look forward, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale, bow, exhale, rise, inhale, hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, rise up, exhale, bow. Inhale, halfway, chaturanga, exhale. Inhale, rise, down dog, exhale, beautiful. Lift your heels, inhale, bend your knees, look forward, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow. Inhale, halfway. Chaturanga, exhale. Rise, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Inhale, lift the heels. Stretch back, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Bow, exhale. Chair, inhale. Navasana. Really nice, really nice. Right knee in, Ardha Navasana with a knee in. Take the leg up if it's okay. Back up, Navasana. Left knee in, Ardha Navasana, maybe extend that left leg up. Navasana. Right knee in, lower down, Ardha. Navasana. Left knee in, lower down. Again, right side. Rise up. Left side. One more each way. One more. Back up. Cross your shins, downward facing dog. Beautiful. However you want to get to down dog. Fantastic. Smooth out your breath. Inhale, right leg back. Knee to your chest, exhale. Place your foot forward. Right hand to the sky. Right hand comes down. Back heel roots, block if you need it, triangle. Push, push, push that right foot down to straighten the leg. Wrap open. So it's not just about pushing the knee to straight. Press the foot to lengthen that leg and take it into that straightened position. Inhale, reverse back. Good, pivot your right toes. I'm gonna pivot my whole self. Pivot your right toes, right hand comes down. Left hand reaches up. Left hand reaches over for your right foot. Maybe your right hand starts to crawl toward that left foot. Release this through center, both arms down, hands down, whatever feels good here, Prasarita Padottanasana. If you're a headstander, you have time. You can take the legs up. If you've taken a headstand, straddle back down. Everyone lengthen halfway. Heels and toes open. We're just going to go side to side here. Doesn't matter which side you start with. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. You're going to end on the right side. A little pause, Skandasana. Bring your hands top of the mat. Step back plank, breath in. Your path to down dog. Beautiful. Inhale, left leg back. Left foot forward. Right hand reaches up. Good, bring it around and down. The back hand, or the back heel rather. Back hand, back heel. Push the hand and the foot down to rise open. So push your foot down, push your hand down, whatever the surface is. that you're not leaning into the hand at all. Yes. Yes, yes. With an inhale, reverse this up and back. Come up and pivot the left foot. Right hand to the sky. And then reach that right hand through over toward the left foot. And if you want, left hand can walk over toward the right foot. It might catch the foot. I'm going with a little distance today so that I'm really spacious. Kind of what my body's dictating more than anything. It wasn't that thoughtful of a choice. Last inhale, unravel, just come through center. Headstand if you want it. Headstanders down. Everyone lengthen out. Heels and toes open, side to side. Let your breath dictate when and how you move. We're going to finish on the left side. We're going to hold in Skandasana for a few breaths. Bring your hands top of the mat. Make your way to downward facing dog. And Madhyasana, bringing your feet as wide as they need to be, as narrow as you're comfortable with. Nice, really nice, yes. Anything you want to do with your arms here. One more inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Release your hands. Drop your head. Balance the weight in your feet. Find your center. So you don't feel like your energy is all
going predominantly in one direction, forward or back, or one side to over the other. Just feel very much centered here. Inhale, rise all the way up. And release your arms, exhale. Beautiful. Bring your feet together-ish, together-ish. Chair, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Halfway up, inhale. Make your way to downward facing dog. Right leg back, inhale. Bring your right knee to your right elbow. Bring your right foot over toward your left elbow. Push the ground away. Little floating pigeon. And then place your shin down. Active pigeon here. It's an active pigeon. Inhale, reach up if you can. You can use your back toes however you want. You can use your front shin to get a little length here. Beautiful. One more inhale, hands release down. Plank inhale, your path to down dog. Left leg back, inhale. Left knee, left elbow, left foot toward right elbow. Push the ground away, hollow out your center. And then shin comes down and forward. Lifting up. Right hip working, shin on the left leg pressing down to give you some buoyancy here. Hands release down, plank inhale, chaturanga exhale. Rise, inhale, down dog exhale. Inhale, lift your heels. Bend your knees, malasana. Inhale, heart lifts. Forward fold, exhale. Rise to stand, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, reach up. Good, chair, sink, I almost forgot. Hands down. Hands down. Rock your weight forward. Rock your weight back, chair. I'm going to go on an angle here. Inhale. Exhale. Rock your weight forward. Rock your weight back. You're back in chair. This is perfect. This doesn't have to change. If you want, we're going to take this into like a little handstand hop. I like to cross at my ankles. And interestingly enough, I apparently always cross with my right in front, so I'm going to try to do it with my left in front. Yes. Oh my God, I don't even know how to do it. Like, I really don't know how to get my left foot. There it is. Wow, that was awkward. Next chair, come back into chair. Forward fold, exhale. Beautifully done. Do you like how I just said next chair, come back into chair? That made no sense. Next chair, stay in chair. Now that we're out of it, I'll clarify what I meant. Halfway, inhale. Make your way to downward facing dog. Right leg back, inhale. That floating pigeon, bring the shin forward. Place the shin down. Rise, inhale. Release your hands down. Plank, inhale. However you want to get to down dog. Left leg back, inhale. Shin forward, float it, place it down. Rise up, hands down, plank, inhale, your path down dog. Inhale, heels up. Knees bend, feet to your hands. Chair, right into your chair. Good, pick up your right leg. Sink, little kick. Come back into chair. Left knee lifts, sink, kick, chair. It's not meant to be pretty, y'all. And you're just gonna keep alternating that. And I kind of like it with knees bent the whole time because it's like different than how we normally kick up, right? Normally we're like leg is long and we're sweeping the leg up. Maybe just try it with bent knees and see what happens. Yes. Yes. So good. And then next time, chair, you'll hold. That's what I meant to say last time. Forward fold, exhale. Halfway inhale. Make your way back to down dog. Right leg is back. Shin is forward. This time your pigeon is quieter. We're not here for that much longer though than the first one we did.
But you get to bring the torso forward if it feels good. Bring your hands under your shoulders, tuck your back toes, your pathway back, down dog. Left leg back, inhale. Shin comes forward, pigeon. Bring your hands under your shoulders, tuck your back toes, make your way back to down dog. This is your last chaturanga if you choose to take it. Hi, Lulu. I heard you jump down. We're going to make our way onto your back so you can just flip right over. Really good work, y'all. Hi. Come here. Okay. Block under your sacrum if you have one. Knees come up. And then legs come up. Hi. Bend your knees, bring your feet back down to the ground. You can stay on the block or you're in a bridge and lift up. If you're on a block, stay. If you're in an active bridge, release down. Repeat bridge again or upward facing bow. Release down. Stay on the block if you're on it, unless you're done, like you've had enough, that's fine. One more back bend if you want. Rise, inhale.
and back down. Pause. Take your feet wide, drop your knees into each other. Bring your hands onto your belly if it's okay. Feel your breath, feel your heart rate. Take both knees over to the right. If it feels good, hook your right ankle on the outside of your left knee and give your hip a little more attention coming across. Root your left shoulder, stretch the left arm to the left. Back to center and cross if you have that little cross, and then take the knees to the left, and if you want, left ankle can kind of hook that knee, right arm out to the side, right shoulder nice and heavy. Back to center. Hug your knees into your chest. Rock up to sitting. Rock up to sitting. And we're just going to finish the same way we started. So I'm actually going to employ a block this time. Come here. So shins move kind of forward. Feet move forward. Hands on your thighs. Let your eyes soften. Started, we were focused on balancing the breath, on counting it. You don't have to do that now at all. In fact, embrace the natural cadence of the breath. And when we began the practice, I asked you to notice what you bring onto your mat today. And now I ask you to notice what you're going to take off of your mat after your practice. With an inhale, draw your hands together at your heart. Bow your mind to your heart. Rise, eyes open gently. Thank you for your practice. Thank you for being here.